sine I1 is equal to N sine R1. Okay, I am having R1 also and I1 also and R1 also. See, sine. Okay, I1, how much is there? Where is I1? Where is that I1? Which equation we are having? Okay, here. So from what is the equation number 3? This we can take 6. This we can take 7. Okay, from equation number 6. From equation number 7 and, sorry, 6 and 7. 6 and 7. Okay. From 6 implies I, 7 implies R1. Okay, I1 is equal to how much? Dm plus A divided by 2. Next, here R1 is equal to how much? A by 2. Okay, substitute from equation number 6 and 7, from 6 and 7. Okay, 6, 7, 6 and 7. Substitute in, so 6 and 7 substitute in equation number 5. What is that 5 equation? That is sine I1, how much is there? Dm plus, this is all divided, not by this is, okay, dm plus a divided by 2. Next, n sine r, r how much is there? A by 2. Okay, send this side. What happened? N is equal to sine dm plus a whole divided by 2 divided by sine of a by 2. Okay, this equation we are calling the refractive index of the prism or refractive index of the any material. From this, see, what is that N? Refractive index of the prism. Next, what is that angle of the prism? Okay, angle of the prism, how much will be there? If it is equilateral triangle, definitely 60 degrees will be there. So this also 60. Then we can find this dm value also. Dm means minimum deviation. So minimum deviation we can derive from this point also. Where is that? This. So not here, here also we can derive simply. If you know the incident angle and A is equal, then we can get the dm value also. This is the final expression for the N is equal to sine of A plus, or else we can write like this also, another equations. In general, N is equal to sine of A plus dm whole divided by next sine of A by 2. Both are correct only. This also correct, this also correct. So dm plus A by A divided by 2 or A by 2, both are correct. This is the refractive index of the prism.